If you vote the way you've always voted, you'll get what you always got, and we'll end up where we've always been, at the bottom of the map.
A few days ago, I told you about Lee Carter running for governor in Virginia. Well, today I have another announcement of somebody running, this time for a congressional seat in Louisiana's 2nd District. Gary Chambers. Now, before I get to his announcement video, let me show you why you may recognize Gary Chambers. So, this was over the summer, June 22nd, 2020. Baton Rouge activist Gary Chambers speaks out in viral video demanding Confederate school name change. So, this is a moment that went so viral that LeBron James tweeted about it. I'm not going to play the two-minute clip here. Of course, I'll link to all the sources below the video if you do want to remind yourself of what this was about. But there is a clip of it in his announcement video, so you will see a part of it. But this is somebody who is a Baton Rouge activist, somebody who's been on the ground working with people his entire life. And now he is running for Congress. This is exactly the kind of person you want representing you in Congress. So let me play for you his announcement video.
Most of you know me from this video with Connie.
So I had intended to get up here and talk about how racist Robert E. Lee was, but I'm gonna talk about you, Connie. Sitting over there shopping while we talking about Robert E. Lee.
But I'm gonna talk about Louisiana today. The people of Baton Rouge know me for fighting for healthcare access in North Baton Rouge, helping change the name of Lee High School to Liberty High, fighting to keep the zoo in North Baton Rouge, and a $300 million investment coming to a divested community. Because change doesn't just happen, we fight to make change happen. Most of your run-of-the-mill politicians, career politicians, will tell you we're doing a great job. But the truth is, we understand that they haven't been taking care of the health, welfare, and the safety of our community. The numbers don't lie. Folks that grew up on streets like this, on Oreo, like me and my complex family story. My mother committed suicide when I was 2 months old, and my father struggled with alcoholism. So my village stepped in, and my aunt and uncle became my mother and father. And communities like Oreo Street and all over this country understand that our fight for change requires that we come together the same way my family did to help bring me forth. We've got to bring our state forward so our children have a state that they can live in, thrive in, and prosper in instead of leaving for what they see as greener pastures. We've got to fight for clean air and green jobs because we understand with the closure of Shell in Convent and the hundreds of jobs that we're losing, if we marry our state to one industry, we are married to their prosperity or their demise. And the future of jobs for our children requires that we look at the Green New Deal. This global pandemic that has shown us the inequities that exist in our healthcare system means that we have to fight for Medicare for all, to give every American a fair shot when they get sick. The truth is, profit should not be the determining factor of the quality of care you get when you go see a physician. It should be about health care and serving people. You have inspired me to jump into this race, to go and fight in Washington for change for all people. I am unapologetic in my positions and unafraid to speak truth to power. It's what I know how to do best, and it's what we need in DC. What I'm asking you to do is take this journey with me. From East Baton Rouge to West Baton Rouge, to Iberville, Ascension, Assumption, St. James, St. John the Baptist, St. Charles, Jefferson, and Orleans, through all of Louisiana's 2nd Congressional District. We deserve a fighting chance for our children to live out their wildest dreams right here in this state. But we can't be satisfied with being dead last, and we can't elect career politicians if we want change to happen. If you vote the way you've always voted, you get what you always got, and we'll end up where we've always been, at the bottom of the map. And what I'm asking you to do is take a walk with me on this journey for change, and let's go make equity, justice, and progress for all people a priority in Washington, D.C. I'm Gary Chambers, and I'm running for Congress. I need your support. I need your prayers. I need you to volunteer and organize, because if we strategize, organize, and mobilize, we're going to win this thing, y'all. Do good. Seek justice. I see you at work.
All right, so first up, I got to say, do good, seek justice is a fantastic tagline. And this is clearly somebody who fights for his community. Supports issues as well, like Medicare for All, Green New Deal, but also has been there in his community as a vocal member fighting for them. This is exactly the kind of person you want representing you in Congress. So, of course, I'm going to link to his page below the video. Join up, get updates on his campaign. You could also, of course, support him with a donation. And just to give you an idea of, or to give you the full context here, this is for Cedric Richmond's seat, who's now going to be in the Biden administration. So there's this vacancy now. The I'm not sure if an actual election date has been called, but I believe it's supposed to be sometime in March. So so sometime in the next several months, that's when you'll see this this election. So pay attention, support Gary Chambers, and of course, I'll link to all this below the video.